This video is a part of a series of videos on staking to lines within Leica Captivate. It will show how to use the Stake to Line app for staking a line or a segment of a line. The video follows on from the Staking a Line overview video and uses the example house project, where several different lines form a road, a building footprint, a service line, and a pipeline. Let's take a look at where our line might come from. As mentioned in the Staking to a Line overview video, the line can simply be a line between two points or a polyline with multiple points and segments, which can be made up of straights and arcs. To be used in the Stake to Line app, the line must exist in normal job. Either the line already exists in a job, for example, it was already measured or imported, or it will need to be created, for example, by importing attached CAD data or creating a new line between existing points. Within the Stake to Line app, it is possible to import a line from attached CAD data, create a line based on existing points in the job, or to import a line from another job. Accessing the Stake to Line app. Accessing the Stake to Line app is as simple as choosing the job on the job carousel and then tapping on the Stake to Line icon in the home screen, where a list of tasks appears to choose from. We will look at the tasks in a moment, but before that, let's look at an alternative way of accessing the Stake to Line app. From the home screen, we access the 3D viewer to see our job data. Here, we are able to visually inspect our data, and by tapping and holding on the line we are interested in, we are presented with a context menu, where we can choose Stake or Measure Line, and then selecting Stake Line, for example, we can jump straight into the Stake to Line app with the task and correct line already selected for us. Task: stake a straight line. When accessing the Stake to Line app from the home screen, the first screen we will come to is the task screen. Here we can choose what we want to do. For example, whether we want to stake a line or a segment of a line, whether we want slope information at the same time, if we want to stake a theoretical line between two points using quick line, or stake out a grid of points using a line as a baseline. The graphic on the left gives a good representation of each method. Within this video and other Stake to Line videos, the other tasks will be looked at in more detail. For now, we'll choose line. The Define Line screen is where we choose our line to work with. Any lines that already exist in the job are listed here, with details about the line. The 3D viewer shows the line and all other data in the job, and offers further functions, which we will look at later in the video. From height, we can choose what will define the height to be staked as we stake the line. For example, the stake height can be defined by the line itself, it can be entered manually by the user, or determined from the start point of the line. If a digital terrain model was chosen as design data, we could also select DTM to use the DTM height. The Shifts option allows us to make a temporary change to the line by either entering a horizontal or vertical shift so the line is moved for the duration of this task. If the line we want to stake does not yet exist, we can either create the line from points or import it. First, let's look at creating the line by going to Create. We access the Create Points and Lines app, where we can choose existing points or enter values based on points to create our line, from a simple point-to-point line segment to a multi-segment polyline. We first choose how we want to create the line. In this case, we will just create a line between two points, which will form our service line into the house. We enter our line ID and choose the start and end point of the line. It will be easier to use a 3D viewer for this, so we tap 3D viewer and then tap on the start and end point that will define our line. Now, if we wanted to add another segment to the line we could press next, but because we are finished, we simply press finish. We are automatically returned to the define line screen with a new line selected. If our line already existed, but was in another job, we could access the line selection screen and press import to choose a different job to import the line from. But we don't need to do that right now, so we will press OK and OK again to confirm that we have correctly chosen our line. The next screen we come to is Define Stake. Here we choose where our stake position is relative to the line by entering a distance along the line, an offset across the line, or an offset in height. We can also choose that the stake position along the line can be incremented manually or even automatically after measuring each point. For now, we will keep it simple and leave all values as they were to start our staking at the beginning of the line. Now we are ready to actually stake out. Notice that the stakeout screen is very similar to all stake apps within Leica Captivate. On the left are pages of values and inputs. On the top right is the 3D viewer, which consists of 2D, 3D, Navi and stake views, and underneath values of our current position relative to the point to stake. Note that we will need a distance in order to get our current position. Here we have our current height, our height difference, the difference along the line, and the difference across the line. We will stake out the point in the stake view using the Help Me Navigate Using Line Being Staked option. The graphics guide us to the point based on the line orientation. Watch the video on how to stake a point to learn more about the different views and how the staking process works. In this example, I am trying to mark out on the ground surface where the service line will be located, so I am only interested in the 2D position. Once we position ourselves close enough to the point, we can press store if we want to record the position, and then we are returned to the define stake screen, ready to define the next position to stake. So we can enter 5 meters further along the line and begin staking that. Notice in the 3D viewer how Leica Captivate has drawn our previously staked position as a stake peg, so we can differentiate it from other points. Stake a polyline. We have seen an overview of staking a simple line, so let's move on to staking a more complex line and introduce some new features. This time we will stake out the building footprint corners, offsetting the footprint 2 meters away from the building, so that the foundations of the new house can be dug. We will start in the task screen again and choose line. Now in the define line screen, we realize that our building footprint does not exist as a line in the job, so we must import it from the attached CAD data. We go to 3D viewer, tap on the CAD line, tap and hold, and select import. Leica Captivate now imports the line into the job, along with the line vertices as points. The imported line is already selected, so we press OK to continue to the define stake screen. Here we want to apply a minus 2 meter offset to offset the stake position to the left of the line, and we will set an increment of 20 meters. Actually, this is a little trick, because we know our building is not 20 meters big, but it will mean that the stake position along the line can be incremented directly to the corners using the function keys. Before we enter into the stake screen, we will make some changes to the settings, which are appropriate for our task. We press Function and then Settings, which we could do from anywhere in the app. As we are interested in viewing a summary after each of our measurements, we will enable View Results after staking a point. We will choose Help Me Navigate by facing the instrument. We want to stake out, ensuring the accuracy requirement is met, so we will check differences before storing, checking the positions are within 20 millimeters. Because we want to stake the corner positions of the offset line, we will enable to stake the points of interest, in particular the bisected point. This automatically creates temporary points to stake based on the geometry of the line, for example where the angle points or tangent points are, or offsetted bisected points are. We have finished with the settings, so we will confirm with OK and then press OK again to continue into the stakeout screen. When we first arrive here, we can see that the current stake position is at the beginning of the project, indicated by the BOP in the title line. We are only interested in the bisected points, so we will increment the stake position along the line using the stake plus function key until we reach our first bisected point, indicated by BP. We can see in the 3D viewer that the stake position appears at the correct place. So we will switch the view to a stake view, and now Leica Captivate will guide us towards the point, relative to facing the instrument. As we get close, we see the bullseye appear to help us with the fine positioning, and then we get the quality control indicators telling us that we have met the required accuracy. We measure the point for our records, and as configured, we get a summary of our staked point. Note that it is possible to see a report of all the staked points from the Define Line screen by pressing Function and then Report. To stake out the next bisected point, we simply press Stake Plus until the next BP appears, and start the stake process again, until we have completed our task. Stake a segment. The final task we will perform in this video is to stake out part of the pipeline. For this task, we don't want to stake out the whole pipeline, but we are interested in one segment of it, to check that an extension of this in the future will avoid the building. Starting in the task screen, we choose Segment, and then press OK. We choose the line that contains the segment in the 3D viewer, but then realize that the line direction is wrong, so we press Reverse to reverse the line, and then press OK. Now we have the screen where we must choose which segment of the line we want to work with, and have Leica Captivate ignore all other segments during the staking process. Again, this is easier in the 3D viewer, so we just tap on the segment we are interested in, and then press OK. This time, we want to stake out every 5 meters along the line, and have Leica Captivate automatically increase the distance along after each measurement. We access the settings, as there are some settings to change. Because we are staking a pipeline, we now want to use chainages rather than referring to a distance along. And here we will just disable the view results after staking. We want to be able to customize the info page so that we see just the values relating our position to the line. So we go into Info, clear the existing values, and then add in the 3 bits of information we are interested in. We press OK to confirm all changes, and now we see that the distance along line values have been replaced with chainages. We know that we want to start at chainage 120, so we enter that, and then press OK to go into stakeout. After being guided to the stakeout point, we are able to check our personalized values, and then measure the point. As we can see, the next point to stake has been automatically incremented for us, so now we can stake out many points with minimal input. We quickly realize that there could be a conflict with the pipe extension, but thanks to Leica Captivate, we can advise that the pipe extension would need to be rerouted. We have seen in this video how to stake various lines and had an overview of the powerful features and settings available in the Stake to Line app. Other videos will continue with this house project to show staking a line with a slope and also staking a grid of points, all using the Stake to Line app. Thanks for watching.